Brandy, good morning. This morning, the mother in the case that really started this whole scandal will appear in court. This will be Elsa Oliver's first time appearing in court since Team 5 Investigates broke the news that the body of her 5-year-old son, Jeremiah Oliver, had been found by the side of the road. And that's just one of the cases that is putting DCF in the hot seat today. Now, new this morning, we're learning that the Fitchburg newborn that died on Saturday was also part of a family being monitored by the Child Welfare Agency. A spokeswoman tells the Herald that since 2-week-old baby Irish's, I should say Bailey Irish's death, an abuse and neglect order has been filed with the agency. She also says the family missed a scheduled visit from DCF on Friday. Meantime, Grafton's police chief is firing back against reports that his officers dropped the ball in the death of a baby girl there. As you saw first on 5, Grafton officers filed a report about possible abuse after responding to Upton Street on April 3rd for reports of a baby that would not stop crying. State social workers overlooked that fax report for 6 days when they responded 4-year-old Aliana Levine was dead. DCF says that Grafton police failed to follow procedure by not verbally reporting their suspicions. We went to the police chief for answers.
This requirement is clearly indicated on the mandated reporter form and was not met in this instance, so no verbal notification was made by the reporter.
Well, I'm investigating that myself to make sure what they say is true. I have to take it with a grain of salt right now. I know for a fact that when they are called, they say, send us a report via fax.
The chief adds that DCF also got a call from a resident who lives in the apartment complex, but that call was never returned. And all of this leading to new calls for the resignation of DCF Chief Olga Roach. We'll be following every development. We'll bring you all the new details as soon as we have them. Live in Worcester this morning, Todd Kiskevich, WCVB, News Center 5.